Alrighty. I've been having all, everything was working fine until I went to set up the cell phone. And then everything went to hell. So, okay, let me get this undone there. Alrighty, Super Dave, how you doing? Yeah, sorry it took so long to get things set up. 7 minutes past the deadline. So, yeah, how you doing? What we are doing here is I bought a new ham radio a couple of weeks ago. And yeah, how you doing, Dave? You're the only one here so far. But anyway, I bought a new ham radio a couple of weeks ago, and it's a little dinky guy. It's for portable, runs on 12 volts, and it's an all mode HF radio. Now, what that means is I can get on any of the high frequency bands with this radio, which is what most of the ham radio frequencies and bands consist of for voice, CW, which is, Morse code, and digital, FT1 and things like that. So anyway, it does everything that a big expensive ham radio would do, but this thing's only 470 bucks. It's a little tiny thing, and for the last 2 weeks I've been running it in my living room at my regular ham station. And I have talked all over the world on it, all over. This morning, I got on it with my coffee, and the first person I talked to was a guy named Milo in Slovenia, which is near Hungary and all that. It's mixed up right there in the middle of all those countries. And at first, I thought I'd been to that country before on ham radio, but it wasn't. It was another radio station that I talked to in Slovakia, which is one country up and to the right a little bit. So I've been talking all over the world, Italy, Japan. Last night I talked to Japan before I got off the radio. And in the morning, yesterday morning, I talked, when I got up with my coffee, I talked to the Netherlands, a guy in the Netherlands. So I can talk anywhere in the world with this radio with just a simple 5/8 wave vertical antenna. So anyway, I have developed a portable antenna system that will go up on a 30-foot mast, and I can set this up anywhere. So when I'm traveling, I'm going to be running this radio here in out of my trailer. Anyway, here's what it looks like. I can't do the camera turnaround on this thing, so I have to just point it and hope that you can see it. Let me watch it come up on the screen here. I'm waiting for the delay. There we go. Yeah, okay, so you can see that real good. There it is. And it's just a beautiful radio. I mean, it's tiny, I mean, here's my hand as a comparison right here. So that's pretty small. And it's practically it's like the size of good two good size walkie-talkies is what it is. So that's what we're going to be using once I set up the antenna. And so I thought I would, set the antenna up in front of you guys so you can see how that works. Now here's the power. Here's what I'm going to be using for power, the talent cell 12 volt 24 ampere hour LiFePO 4. It's a boy, I ran this all last week and never got it down below 50%. So that's absolutely amazing. I couldn't believe it. And then also I can run it off my Gracell T300, which is a little 300 watt rechargeable power station. So it'll run off either one of these. I'm just going to run it off this one right now. I also have a solar cell, 100 watts of portable solar cell that I can charge that with, or I can even charge my other system with it, the big system. I've got another 200 watts of portable panels that you guys have seen before. They're heavy. They're the big, real panels. This is the little carry around. I'm going to probably get another one because this is only 100 watts. I want 200 watts. I could have bought a 200 watt one, but I wanted to be able to use just 100 watts also. Because a lot of times I'm not going to need 200 watts and I can just carry that thing and I don't need the battery. I can carry that. And I can carry the radio, and I can pack up a little antenna that rolls up in my pack. It's a wire antenna, not what I'll be using today. If you've been to any of my other portable, like field day, ARRL field day videos, you've seen me use wire antennas there before, and I have different mast systems for that. All righty. So, yeah, let's go ahead and put up the antenna and get all this going. And I can't wait to see my SWR. So SWR is standing wave ratio, which tells you if your antenna is resonant at the at a frequency that you desire, which means your antenna works at that frequency. This radio has an internal tuner, and it'll tune anything. You could tune a trash can to work as an antenna with that tuner that's in there. It's amazing. But we're actually using an antenna that's tuned to 10 meters. And by all rights, I should get close to a one-to-one match, which is what we're going for. So let's go out here. And I'm going to put this phone in another doohickey here. So let me get it off of here. And we'll put it right in here. Am I right side up? No, I'm upside down. Wait a minute. Got it upside down. I think this is the way I want it. Yeah. What happened? Oh. What happened? Oh, there we go. I touched a button by accident. I'm sorry. I was setting the phone up, and I touched the button by accident. It's bright out here, and I can't see too well. This is the first day of sun we've had in a month, I think. So, yeah, there we go. All righty. So, let's see here. We'll get back a ways. You can see everything I'm doing. And, yeah, you should be able to see everything there. Just like that. And we'll just go in here and see what it looks like down there. I can't see the
Super Dave, the sunspots do make the reception amazingly good.
The sun is in a awake cycle right now. It goes in cycles of 11 years, and it's been in the wake-up cycle for a few years now. This is something that they don't tell you about the weather and stuff when they tell you about we're all going to die, is that the sun has mostly to do with our weather. The sun's the biggest effector. And right now, we're in a, an awake cycle of the sun. So a lot of weird things are going to happen and have been happening, especially to electronics. When these, when the solar radiation that comes out of these CMEs from the sun, which is basically just explosions of corona mass. They call it a corona mass ejection, CME. And it just goes, and when that hits us, boy, it really lights up our ionosphere, our magnetic field lights up. And boy, the radio waves just go crazy. But it can also mess with your electronics, goof up your phone and change settings and stuff when you're not looking. So when you think something like that is happening, you go, what's going on with my phone or my computer? Just restart your computer because that's happening. We don't have any control over that. We can't control it. So, and that really affects the weather. So, that's 90% of the effect of weather up there. Anyway, it's a beautiful effect today. It's beautiful, sunny, and all that. So here's the deal. First thing I got to do is I got to drill a hole in the ground. Well, actually, the first thing that I've got to do is put this up. And that's to hold the mast against the trailer. I'm going to leave this on when I get it up there. So let me get the drill bit. Like I said, I can't see the chat right now, so you just have to bear with me. You guys can talk amongst yourselves. We're doing ham radio stuff here. I have a technician's license, and I'm studying right now for my general, which will allow me on a lot more bands than what I'm allowed on now. So it'll be fun when that happens. It's good to have my upgraded license within a month or two. All right, so we're going to want that basically right about here. So I'm going to pull out one screw here. All right. Screw here. I'm going to have to drill the other hole. I wouldn't even bring a drill bit out. Let's see, but I'll just put it in for the drill bit. You know, I think that'll work. Doggone. Oh, this will work. I'll find it. I went and throw it on the ground. Maybe up there or on my table in there. Oh, okay. Solid. I'll have to do something about that, but that'll hold it for now. Might have to go home. I have to. Then you go get a little hole. Be right back. Entertain yourself. I need a new bit that size. Oh my God. I don't know what I hit. That's either some really solid wood or I need a bit. That bit must be gone. I've been replacing them lately. Didn't know I needed to drop them too. Yep. It's a lot of work. Should have drilled it in sometime here. It's a lot of work right now.
I mean, we're only going through soft aluminum and wood there. So that bit is really, oh yeah. So that's a, oh, 3/16. Could have used it. 7/6, 30 seconds, isn't it? Yeah, okay. Anyhow, okay. That's up. So that'll work. Put this away. Alrighty, now what we want to do, we want to find out where the antenna is going to sit. Let's mount it on that thing. So, open this guy up. Now, this guy probably needs one too. Ready? Next. If I don't put this back on here, I'll lose the little washer. All right, now, you get the antenna here. Put that right there. So that. Fits in here for travelers. So there's a 30-foot mast right there. And this is the antenna that goes on top of it. This is an all-band antenna, and it's tunable. That's why you see that wire on it. So we're going to set that right here for the time being. You don't need these. I had another idea I was going to use those for. Now, let's see. We will go up. I've got a thing on here for guy wires. I want to go up the whole 30 feet. So we have zero wind. But right now, what we want to do basically is get the hole at the bottom and go back. So that would be right about. Right about there, I would think. And right about there. Okay, I'm gonna put it there. And go ahead and set it up. Set it up. I've never tried this thing. It's brand new, I've never used it before. I have a bigger drill if I need it. But we'll see how this works. I have a bigger drill motor if needed. Let's see here. Right there. And you can't see that.
I'll bring you over. All right, now you ought to be able to see what I'm doing, I think. Yeah. So,
I'm going to drill a hole. They had a mark in the ground right here. Boy, it works good. Oops. Keep the dirt from going back down in there.
I've got really good soil here.
Go deeper.
You hit rocks. Yeah, that'll do it.
That's a nice hole.
Go. Can you see that? All right, so now I put this right down in there. It's like that. I got a little crooked. Well, doesn't matter. I mean, won't hurt the reception any. Needed it over this way a little bit more, but that's okay. Don't worry. Be happy. Yeah, it's a little off center, but that's okay. Doesn't really matter. So, I don't know what you're looking at. See, with StreamYard, it's not like when I'm broadcasting on just YouTube. With StreamYard, I can't turn the camera around. And I also can't see the... Let's see, where's comments? Can't find... There it is. Okay. Handheld radio. If you're just talking about a technician class license, well, you can get on HF because they give you a taste of it, which is what I'm doing today, where you can talk all over the world. But if you want to get on the local repeaters, a dual band 2 meter 70 centimeter radio. The Bofangs are fine to get started. And you're talking, get the 7 or 8 water. It's 8 watts, I think. Get the 8 water, the dual band Bofang. You'll get started like that. Get into the local repeater and start meeting people. They have club meetings for the repeaters and stuff like that in your area. And start getting on the internet and following some channels where you're learning stuff about antennas, because that's the most important part. The radio's nothing. Learn about the antennas. That's where it's really at. That's how I'm able to talk all over the world on this little 20-watt radio. So, and when you get your general license, you're allowed all over the HF bands, not just 10 meters, and you're allowed up to 1,500 watts. So, you know. But I talk to these guys, they're on 1,500 watts, and they go, what are you running? I go, oh, 20 watts into a little tiny vertical antenna. So, wow, you're coming in really good for that. Yeah, I know. Anyway, we'll put this on. Now I've got coax. I'll show you. My antenna wire runs into the trailer already. And I just keep it all coiled up and stuff in this box. I've also got Starlink. I've got multiple ways of getting power through solar batteries and all that stuff. And so here, you see, I've got my Starlink cable coming out. The antenna's over there. I'm not using it right now because I also have internet here because I'm at home. This is the coax cable. It's 50 feet. Here's my internet network cable that comes in from the shop. And a grounding line that you see right here for grounding the radio. This helps with interference and stuff. And also... possibly a little, you know, like I need to run another wire to this big, thick, soft wire, but we don't have any lightning today. So I'm not worried about it because I can put a lightning cable on this post also. This is solid copper. It's 2 feet long. And we don't need to go too deep, but just enough. The ground's good and wet. That'll work. So that gives me a good ground. All right. So everything goes into the trailer right there. And you notice I have a tarp on the trailer right now. I got to do a reseal on the J-rail. And I'm going to do that because I'm not going to restore this one right away. And I want to use it this summer. But I want to quit having to use a tarp. So the only places it's leaking is the J-rail, which is this stuff, this trim, like you saw me drill through a little bit ago. This drip edge is also what it's called. I need to take that all off, putty it up, new putty tape, put it back on. Now, if you look back in my videos, my live videos, I did a series, and it's all in a playlist, of resealing a trailer just like this. It's exact same profile and everything. It was a Shasta, but, you know, these guys all copied each other during the years, just like they do now. So, let's hook up the antenna. Okay, you can see it all up there now. Let's see what you can see. God, I get in the way and I can't see what you see. You know, that's too bad. I had to talk to StreamYard about that. They don't make it easy to turn the camera around when you're using their program.
Just don't make it easy. All right, so let me bring the coax cable over here. And of course, it's all angled up. And it's barely got a little bit of cut. You know, they package everything so small now. This stuff comes like a slinky almost. Almost like opening a slinky. So, anyway.
Now I'm going to raise it up, but I'm not going to raise it up all the way, I don't think, but we can. I might do that later. First, let's just get it up there a ways and see if we get anything. If we want to go higher, we can. So, it's in the hole, in the ground. And, we'll put up a flag, too. I'm not even going to raise it all the way. We'll go like that for right now. Yeah, that works. Yeah, it's a little crooked, dang it. I blew it. I'll get better. It's the first time I did this. All right, now I need that other screw. But I could just back the trailer up 2 inches. That would work. It's really about an inch and a half off. Yeah. We need to get some longer bolts. Another half inch would have been perfect. Or an inch. We don't even have to tighten that up. There we go. That's good and solid. It's not going anywhere. So my idea so far, the first time I've tried this, bought all this stuff the last 2 weeks, figuring it out, and so far, it looks good. The feed point is now up, what would you say that is? That's like 7, 14, 15, about 15 feet up in the air. Now, I got those power lines behind me, but most of my DX which is distant transmission, like around the world and stuff, is going in all the other directions except for where those power lines are anyway, east and south. Well, let's go see how that works. You ready? We're going to test it now. First time you get to do it with me. So this ought to be good. Let's see how easily I can do this. Well, that won't work. Okay. So let's do it like this. Hopefully I didn't. Oh, I did. I touched buttons. Oh, heck. What happened? Where was I? Doggone it. All right. Where am I? There we go. Oh, how come the other one is? Wait a minute. What is that doing? There. It's
just me now.
Hello.
Why can I hear me?
All right. Let's see. I don't know why I can hear me. Is I can see that I can see me now. See what happens? I accidentally touch something when I'm moving the camera around. And screws everything up. So, am I back? Yes, Super Dave. Cam test online. Amtestonline.com. That's who I'm going through for my general license right now. And that's who I went through for my technician license. So, all right, now here's the thing. What we want to do first, we want to test the SWR. And the way we do that is with this frequency counter right here. Okay. This is a meter gizmo thing. Gee, they're only about almost $500. Anyway, we're going to plug the antenna in right here and see. You got the door light. Yeah. We're going to plug the antenna in right here and test it, and it will show us up here whether our antenna with coax, ground, and everything is in tune. So let's go ahead and get that going. And see, the thing is, you don't want your antenna to be too far out of tune because you can hurt your radio. Yeah, we're all here to go. So I don't need the guidelines. I can extend it the whole 30 feet. There's no wind. So let me, I have the coax hooked up to the radio already. Let me get that off. And okay. All right, so here's the end of the coax. Here's the frequency counter. I'm gonna plug it in there. All right, now let me get this lit up well so you can see what's going on here. Okay. First of all, let me get the stands to work up. It wouldn't bend over enough before. Okay, there it is. There we go. Glad we got the light. Lighting is the worst part of live work and camera work, is trying to figure out the lighting. There it is. See, now, so we just power it on. All right. And we're at 28 something. 28.26787. We're set on the 28 megahertz level here. And we can tune it now. And it's showing a 1 to 2.5. 28.4 is what we want. Okay, we're at 28.4. That's a terrible reading. It's not what we got before. I got one of these before. So my antenna tuner, have to tune to this. That's the best I can get is 1 to 3.5. Jesus, that's terrible. So I thought it was going to be better now. Yeah, I don't know why. See, this one over here is supposed to be way over there, and it just won't go there. Yeah, it just won't go there. So, yeah, this antenna tunes up too high and frequency. Oh, man. Well, let's see what it does. 28.45. Yeah, we're not getting a call at all. So, let's see if we can tune up to it. Not, I'm going to do something about what I'm doing. I'm trying to think, I can't do anything else. I've used this antenna before with success. So, and like I said, you can tune to a terrestrial. So, let's go ahead and put the dang antenna back on here. I'm pretty sure I've got the antenna itself set right. I don't see a problem anyway. So. All right. Here we go. All right, now I'm going to give you a look at the radio. Let's get this thing out of the way. Other stuff I won't need in the way. As a matter of fact, you know what I'm going to do? Let me bring the tripod in here. Yeah, this would be better. And I have a gimbal, but we don't need it. We're going to be stationary. Yeah, I think it's going to be much better as long as I can get past it, getting in and out. Yeah, I think that'll do it. So now I'm going to try not to touch anything, okay? That's the hard part with all this. Is I touch something and then the screen goes away. I don't know how people do this with a cell phone. Really, very, it's very difficult with a cell phone. It's, unless you can keep your hands off of it. Okay, there. Now you can see everything. Yeah, that's about as far away as I can get. Hopefully, I have the plate proper. Come here. God dang it. Get it all set up and the big feet get in the way. Move everything around. You know, if you want to have a foot, do you have small feet? Would you like larger feet? I'll do a trade with you and go to the local hospital. I'll trade you. All right, now, this thing has feet. I don't want to use these. So, there we go. And the mount that's on this base for this radio, you have to buy it separately. This base here, separately, it's got a fan in it to keep it cool underneath. It blows air up to it. So it actually comes out of the casing, and then the radio is even smaller. So let's turn it on. Oh, let's get some power. It doesn't like to do anything with that power. There we go. Now we got power. All right, now I'm going to first have to tune it. Let's go down to 28.4. Oops. That's digital. Minnesota. All right, let's go down. I'm going to go about 402 where there's nobody at. I'm going to tune the antenna. So all you have to do is hold this button. Let go. That does the tuning itself.
Now I check C012. I push it to center. No, it's terrible. Okay, it's good on this frequency. It's terrible for this frequency, but as soon as you get this frequency, it's good. So, our it's acceptable. That's what it's like. Now it's in contact. CQ on 20 watts. CQ, 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 Kilo 7, Kilo Foxtrot India calling, Kilo 7, Kilo Foxtrot India calling, Kilo 7, Kilo Foxtrot India calling, CQ, 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 on 10 meters with 20 watts. When you know the band would go silent, when some good old radio stream, and it happens, and it'll probably come up again this afternoon. But this is the quietest I've ever heard in a long time since I bought the radio. And that just. And I just. There's so many. Anyone. Alright, let's just make sure about something here. My anger is fake. In Minnesota and Texas and places like that. I'm just gonna look at something out here real quick. Thank you. Kilo 7, Foxtrot, India.
Yeah, they changed the name because they like changing the name. This is originally a flagpole, so you can still use this. Okay, so there is what my whole rig would look like with that antenna fully extended. I'll put the guy rings up one more section. That's what I'll do. And then we'll bring the lines down to guy. In the meantime, there's a fly line and everything. So, of course, that flag's got plenty of room comes up. That flag will make a full one of them. So you only want that if there's no wind. I don't hear it. He went away.
Well, that's 10 meters for you also. It can be 10 meters to be 50.
So,
yeah. Let's see if he thinks about it. He stayed around. I'm going to get a drink. And I'll look at that. And then we'll see him out again. Hard sitting here like that. He's looking for contacts. So he'll talk to me. But he's just not coming in good enough right now. I'm going to try one more tune off frequency. Yeah, let's go here. All right, let's see what it looks like. Oh, again, we got it nice and flat. Okay, nice and flat in the area we're in, so that'll work. All right, so where'd he go? 372. 28.372 is where he's at. All right, I'll go ahead and look at the chat for a bit while we wait for him to get back in. He's just blowing up. It's way over there. See, now the tripod's in the way. He didn't kind of want to get up and down. I got to come up with a better system for the live streams, for, you know, how to hold the camera. But I've been doing this so long now. Going on, I don't know, 18 years. And there's just never anything that works out really well for that. You know? It's just always a big hassle trying to get the camera and the lighting and everything right. It's never ever works out very well for some reason. There's always something. Well, he just faded right away. That's 10 meters for you. It'll be booming 1 minute. And then fade away the next. It's a shame, but that's just 10 meters. Very fickle at times. It was really good all day yesterday. So let me go to the chat and see what you got here. I got to get my eyes to readjust being outside. Let's see.
My audio is choppy. It might be out there. How is it now? How's my audio now, you guys? Not a whole lot of feedback going on here, is it? Am I still on? Hi, Pamela. Pamela, would you say something so that I know the chat's working? Should be. The video's working. He's fading back in, and maybe he'll come in stronger. Is the somebody say something, please, on the chat so I know it's working? Am I broadcasting? I should be. Say something. Say something. Somebody, say something. They all say something. If it works. Still a little rough, huh? I lost the foam thing on there. Can you hear me beating on the mic? Yeah, can you hear me tapping the mic? Can you hear me tapping the mic? I need your feedback. It should be really good. Everything should be great. The video should be great. The audio should be great. Oh, no? Oh, that's why. All right, something happened there. We didn't pick up the microphone. Ah, heck. That's why. Yeah, that's because for some reason it's not using my mic. And you know why? It's probably when we changed. I'm a guest is what it is. I'm a guest. I don't know how that happened. Yeah, because this is the microphone we should be using, and you're not hearing the tap on it, so you're not, it's not. The only thing I can think of is to restart the stream. So if you guys hold on a minute, I'll just restart the stream, and I'll come back with this. When I did that other camera, when I moved the camera, and I lost it and everything, that's what screwed everything up. So I'm going to restart the stream. Come looking for me if you lose me. I don't know if we'll be on this. Wait here a minute and see if it comes back. Okay, so I don't think it will, though. I don't think it'll come back. I'm trying to think how to do this without ending the actual thing. I'm going to do this. I don't want to end the stream. I just want this phone to disconnect and so I can come back on. I don't know how to do that. Really don't know how to do that. Yeah, I don't know how to do that. Darn it. How do I leave? How do I turn it off here? Let me see what stream info says. I'm on the wrong one. I think. Where am I? I'm on. All right. Now there's two of me, I think. I don't know what. Yeah, can you hear me tapping on the mic now? Can you hear that? Bang, 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 bang. Hello? Is anybody there? All right, wait a minute. I think I'm going to fix this myself. All right. Hello? Anybody there? Well, that's a long delay. Okay, that's what I needed to know. For somehow, this got disconnected. It's terrible. These phones have terrible microphones. I don't know how to turn the phone so that it stops and leaves and then comes back. I don't know how to do that. Well, maybe just turn the phone off and then come back in. I'll do that because this is getting ridiculous. Okay. That's what I'm going to do. If you lose me completely, just go back to my channel and look for me again. Because I may have to start a new stream. So what I'm going to do is just turn the phone off. And then hopefully come back in with the microphone working, okay? Because, see, I have a guest here, and I want to get rid of that. Edit mindset. Let's see. Edit the one that I'm using, I can't edit. Yeah. Yeah, I don't know what to do. All right, here we go. So just look for me. I'll try and make this work. Boy, what a horrible failure today. Except the antenna's up and it works. The radio works. We just have lousy conditions all of a sudden. And I can't make the cell phone work for the crap because it's stupid. Hi, Lincoln Bill. I'll be back in a minute. I don't want to hit the end because I want to keep this screen going if I can. I'm just going to turn my phone off or restart it. All right, I think I'm back. I think. I'm waiting myself to see if I come back. There I go. It looks like I'm coming back. All right, I'm there. All right. Okay, new comments. Okay. All right, are we all back here now? Yeah, am I still going on the same stream? At least now I know how to do that. Now, here's what we want to test. I'm going to turn on my sound. All right. Okay, new comments. Okay. All right, are we all back here now? At least now I know how to do that. I'm waiting to see if my mic is... hold on. Here it comes. It's still not working. My microphone doesn't work anymore. That's odd. Well, all right. That thing's not working. I don't know why. So...
I'm waiting to see if my mic is
hold on. I don't know why it doesn't work.
It's still not working. My microphone doesn't work anymore.
Well, some other time. That's not the whole test. Anyway, all right, let's see if we can make a contact on this radio. Let me get rid of the sound here. All right. I don't hear that. All right, here he is, I think. Okay, I don't hear that on the other side. Dallas, Texas. Texas normally comes booming in. So the conditions, I don't know what it is about Texas, but they really boom in. Yeah, the band is just really being fickle. Like I say, I wish that the FT8, the digital, comes in great. I'm not hearing any voice. I talked to this guy yesterday afternoon. He's in Minnesota. They usually come in really good too. They're doing a special event. He's on a lake on the ice in Minnesota. I saw a picture of where they're operating from yesterday. I don't know if he's going to hear me. If he's coming in that bad to me, he's probably not going to hear me. Kilo 7, Zulu Foxtrot, India. QSO, Kilo 7, Zulu Foxtrot, India. We talked yesterday, and I'm testing this station out mobile with 20 watts today. Yeah. QSL, the band just seems to stink right now. It was great this morning when I talked to Slovenia. Now that I want to run a real test, and you're also on video right now on a live stream on my mobile tech channel. This is the first test from the actual mobile camper. QSL? QSL, I sure appreciate the comeback because it helps a lot. And yeah, it is the band, I believe. But you go ahead with your ice station there. I'll give you a 5-4 reception today from Northern Nevada. So 73s, my friend. Kilo 7, Zulu, Foxtrot, India. Oh, he's fading. Well, I don't know how well you heard that, and I wish my microphone would have been working because I could have had it right up there. But that's Minnesota, and you see the radio. And actually, I can talk all over the world on it when the band's good. But today is the worst I've seen it. I've only seen one other day this bad since I bought this radio, and today it's matching it. But I'm going to leave it set up out here. And I'm going to come out here later on and check out and see if the band comes back up. Because it tends to do that. I get most of my DX, which is outside the country of the United States, DX. That's what we refer to as DX. I get most of that in the mornings around 8:30 to 9:30. And in the evenings between 3:30 and 5:30. Now, in the mornings, I seem to get one part of the world. Like around Europe, Hungary, Russia, well, this side of Russia. And then and I also get places like South America. And then in the afternoons, I get places like Japan. Well, this morning I talked to the Netherlands. So, but I get places like Japan and the other side of Russia where Japan is. Some of the islands way up north in Canada, like almost to the Arctic. To the Northern Arctic, I mean, you know, the North Pole type thing. I mean, way out there. So some of these places, I looked their location up on the on Google Earth, and I'm going, why would anybody live there? But if you had to, you'd want one of these. So anyway, let's see. Okay. All righty. Well, not a lot of people responding to my live stream today. Nobody's interested in me anymore. And my channel is slowly, well, not slowly anymore, very quickly dying a slow, horrible death. YouTube doesn't like me for some reason. And actually, I know why, but they don't like me. Google is the one that doesn't like me. I don't think YouTube has anything to do with it. But they have been killing my channel. So I have just given up on trying to have a successful channel. I'm back to just having fun now. I tried removing ads because I figured, well, I'm just in it for the fun. So I'm going to remove all my ads and make it easy on my viewers. And they put ads in there when you don't have any advertising. So the only way to get rid of, you can't get rid of the ads. In other words, I tried, I removed 250 videos, most recent 250 videos out of the 1,000 I have up. 949, whatever it is. And they put ads on them. So they get the money. I'm going, oh, the hell with that. So I redid it back to me again. but yeah. Anyhow, I wanted to share this with you because it's a passion of mine. Oh, here's some more coming in stronger. Let's see who this is. I'll show you this waterfall thing I look at. it helps me tell when there's people on there. As soon as I tune over there, he stops talking. Get in, eh? God. Yeah, this is what happens when I plan stuff, folks. This is why I never plan anything. I just do it on the spur of the moment. Like, what I should have done was before I had this live stream, well, this live stream was basically about setting it up. The next live stream I do out here will be when the conditions are good. We'll see what we could really do with it. I'm also thinking about trying another antenna I have in place of this one. This one, as we saw, it works, but I think the band conditions are the problem right now. Now, and the other problem was it didn't really want to tune to it very well. So I don't really know what I'm putting out full power forward. There's a certain power that gets reflected back if the antenna's out of tune. And what happens is you tune your radio to match the antenna. It's not the other way around. You don't really tune the antenna to match the radio. You're tuning to match what's out there, what the antenna is. And it's not really the radio either. It's just the match between the two, between your antenna and your radio. You want that to be as close to one-to-one as you can. It's impedance is what it is. Anyway, so when you have to tune the radio a lot to get it to match, you're losing power on the output because it's got to dissipate it somewhere, and it's not going out the antenna, and it's not coming back into the radio. So it goes somewhere else, and that's in the tuner, the coil. So that's where it disappears. Anyway, I don't see anything here. That last guy I tried to tune to, that was his last words. And he left. The band is just really bad right now. Now, here's what we can do, just to see if anything else is happening on other frequencies. Let's change frequencies. And I mean, change bands and see what's on another band. Now, I can't talk on the other bands yet because I have to upgrade my license first and I have to pass a test to do that. So let's go over here. One thing I can see, I'm not getting the highest noise level that I normally get in here or around this area.
So we'll check it out before you 351. Make sure it's all working.
See, this is what it should sound like.
It works perfectly, but it all be fine. And then I have for free, I have a TF-440F with the hard drive for free. Just go to any high school amp. College doesn't work. This is what you study. And they give you a college amp. But high school amp, grade school amp, middle school, I don't care. Want to get on here on HF and
trying to let you see that waterfall, but you can't see it.
I will help get on the air. Oh, and it comes with a, well, it's got a building that kind of thing. So, I mean, it's a great way to get on HF for free. But that can't be half, of course. That makes sense.
It's a little waterfall down here.
I've had some luck here lately selling something on the process, so I hope that things go my way. I'll have to think up a couple other things that have been laying around. Who knows,
too much reflection. Just too much reflection.
That's right.
Too much reflection.
There you go, 408. 644-5309. I'm running about 700 watts today. That's not bad.
You can call that guy now if you want to give his phone number on the air.
seems to drive the amplifier just a little better. So I
just can't find it where it doesn't reflect. Too many windows in this camper. It is dark.
Well,
it's dark. You can see it.
Okay,
you get that? Everybody call him. Tell him you just heard him on YouTube. Okay, right. Don't tell him where. Oh, it's another Larry. Very nice. See that? See the waterfall down here, that blue?
Dr. Martin 59. Anyway, I'll bring it to you. Come and check it out. We're going to ship this stuff. He got an empty, I don't know what, they own a mic. The mic, by the time he tried it out, we'll check it out for you. He went $450 for that. It includes the MV1 desk mic. That's a pretty high school student who wants to get on the air. That's a right to start with my hair. He's in high school, in middle age, and all that. No college, though. He'll be, you know, like me, what do you mean, flat radio? Anyway, so help you get it all going and everything.
Yes, but it's
408-644.
No, that ain't no good. Right here.
408-644-5309. Anyway, Larry.
Another Larry. Okay, let's tune to another guy.
But I put a lot of butter on mine and it's salt and a little bit of pepper.
Now we're learning how to cook. I'll show you this if I can get it out of here without her disconnecting the stream again. Let me put it in here so I can hold it without disconnecting the stream. Okay. So I want to show you this part of it. Where's the camera? Yeah, it's over there. So, now you see this line here. Let me tune to something that's not all noise. Jeez.
More than one, you can talk over there for dinner. I figured you'd put some sour cream on their hand, though. Well, you know, actually, I would. I do. We have it. I might even actually do that because it's going to squeeze doobie doobie and just open it up and plop it on. So, yeah, that'll probably happen as well.
We got a lot of noise. A lot of noise.
Yeah, no, baked potato is the skin. And I don't eat the skin. It's not good.
All right, so that's how that works. And now you've seen the whole setup here. Like I say, I have multiple choices of power. I can extend the antenna or bring it down. I'm going to be building other antennas that will definitely tune up better than this one did. I'm not sure what happened between when I tested it inside and out here, but inside I got a 1-to-1 match. Out here I got a 1-to-3.5, which is terrible. So I'm not sure what happened there. But I'm going to be building antennas and then going out camping in the trailer and trying out different types of antennas under different conditions and different situations and circumstances. So, God, they're talking about potatoes. You know, they got thousands of dollars worth of equipment there, and they're talking about how to cook a potato. So, but this stuff will come in really handy if there is an emergency and all the cell phones go down and all that. Then, come on. Why did you do that? How do I get rid of that? It says hide current comment. I don't know why it does that. It's in my way. There, I hid current comment, whatever it was. I didn't mean to, whoever it was. Lake and Trail says, I want one. Yeah. I don't know what comment I hid, but... Lake and Trail, you're in Dallas, and you want to know if we could connect. Not on a handheld. I mean, we could if it was an HF handheld, but... you need a little radio like this first. And then you need to put up a decent antenna, which costs you about $100 for the antenna, maybe another $20 for a mast. It doesn't have to be very high. It wouldn't be like this antenna. It's called a ground plane, and I could send you a link for it. You can pass the test within a couple of weeks easy. It's a real easy test. Study for a couple of weeks on hamtestonline.com, and you'll get your technician license, and then you can come on the air. And if you get one of these, this type of radio, yes, we can talk on 10 meters. Because, see, as a technician, you're stuck on 10 meters. You can't go anywhere else. What we were just listening to there is 40 meters. And, yes, you can use them on the marine. Yeah, marine. Matter of fact, that's what all boats use is HF. They're just on their own little band where either they don't need a ham radio. I mean, a ham license. God, can't even talk today. So, yeah, you can put them on your, like, then you'd use an antenna like this, or maybe a little bit bigger one. But, yeah, you can do it on a boat. No problem. Boats are really good because water makes for a really good ground plane. And that can really extend your transmission and your reception a lot. I'm going to be testing this at Walker Lake. I'm going to go right down by the lake and set up a easy up for shade and a little table. And I'll have this radio and a little battery here, the 24 ampere hour battery, and my laptop. And we'll do the same thing, but it'll be out there next to a lake on a beautiful day. And that then, and hopefully the conditions will be real good too. So, but yeah, this will do all the different bands. Everything that we're allowed to be on, and it'll do digital, and it'll do Morse code. We call that key CW, and so it does everything. digital is kind of like email over ham radio, in case you're wondering. So it's text. It's like texting over ham radio, and you actually can use something like WinLink. And you can do email on a real email server over ham radio. And that's how some of the friends that I have that used to live out in Death Valley before they lost their rights to their cabins and stuff because they made it a national park. But they had, you know, leases that had to run out because they had gold claims out there, gold and silver claims. Well, that's how they did it. Back in like the year 2000, 1999, 1998, that era, 1995 when the internet first came out, right away they got it on ham radio with a server, and so they could do email from out there in the middle of Death Valley without anything like Starlink, and they had no cell phone, no Starlink, no nothing out there. So now this is getting pretty loud. Boy. These guys are really coming in good now. Now, I wonder if that means that the band has changed. Yes, it has. Wow. All right, he's on the call-in frequency where I was. I think I'm tuned to that. I tune to that. Oh, it jumps up. But it's still only 1.7. So that ain't bad. I'm going to tune it here. I'll see if I can get one of these people. Still a lot of digital, but the band is changing, I think. Still weak. It's 4 o'clock there, 2 o'clock here. He's in the Midwest. Yeah, he's in the Midwest. Yeah, he's talking about it'll be better later in the day, probably too. All right, this is Arizona. Yeah, so I think this is the guy we just talked to a little while ago. Yeah, ice station. Yeah, that's the ice station again. So, yeah, still not real good. But yeah, where do you buy your equipment? I bought this radio on Amazon, and I can send you links for everything. This radio is called the G90, made by Xiegu, X-I-E-G-U. So that's X-Ray India Echo Golf Uniform. X-I-E-G-U. It's a Chinese cheap thing, you know. The G90. And it comes all ready to just plug in and use. You don't have to do anything. You got to learn how to use a radio. But now for handhelds, now you can't use this on the repeater frequencies because those are very high frequency and ultra high frequency. So that's something you'd want to get a handheld for or a mobile unit for. I have both. I got radios coming out of my ears. I got every kind of radio you can think of, tube type, chip type, everything. But to get started, I would say get the 2 meter and four. It's 140 megahertz and 440 megahertz. It's 2 meters and 70 centimeters. Those are the bands that it uses. That can get you on the local repeaters so you can meet other ham radio operators. And do a little search in your area and find the local ham radio club or whatever in your area. Let's see. When I ran CB with an 8-foot steel whip, I always waited for nighttime. Got far better skip around 8 p.m. to 2 p.m., 2 a.m. Yeah. And I have a 102-inch whip out there, and I can use that on 10 meters because CB is 11 meters. They're right next to each other. This radio will tune to it just fine. And actually, if I were to cut a little bit off that antenna, it'd work even better because that's a little bit, it's actually lower frequency. I would add to the antenna a little bit, actually, is what I would do. So, like I was saying, I would get the 2 meter handheld, just a Bofang. They're 40, 50 bucks. Get the 8-watt. Get the 8-watt one. And you can use that from the living room of your house as long as there's a repeater around there somewhere. The repeaters are owned by clubs and by individuals. Now, the repeaters that we use here, most of them are owned by individuals, just ham radio operators that just do the expense out of pocket and put up a repeater. And then there's clubs that do it also where you pay dues to support the repeater and the costs and the maintenance and all that stuff. And you'll get involved with your club going up there and doing work on the antennas and the radio gear, and you'll learn from them. And that's the best way to learn because what I can tell you in just a few minutes isn't going to help you much, but I can tell you how to get started in the hobby. So, and you and I can talk on 10 meters all day long. And when the band's not so good, we can go to another band like 40 meters or 20 meters and talk there. Because when one band isn't working so good, the other bands are, like you heard when I switched bands last time. Ice Station, am I coming in a little bit better now? Kilo 7, Zulu Foxtrot, India. He's going to take a new one before me now. But, the band has come up just a little bit. Thank you. he's talking to somebody in Orange City. I just want to see if he comes back to me. Let me see if he... I'm actually, I sent for a certificate from these guys. It's fading again. Doggone it. The band's just not cooperating today. Yeah, that one. Yeah, that's it. Yeah, like that one. He's fading again. Let me see if he comes back to me. Nah, he didn't hear me. All right, well, the band is just terrible today. Of course, because I wanted to show you all, I could have been on here this morning and talking to the Netherlands, crystal clear like they were out in the front yard. But yeah, that would be a handheld to get. They're great. Read the instructions. They work fine for your local repeaters. As long as you're within, say, 60 miles of a local repeater, you should hit it just fine, even from within your living room. And if you go outside, you can get even further. I've been up to 200 miles away from a repeater and used it very successfully before on a handheld. You can also get a little mag mount antenna for the top of your car. So when you're driving around and you're in your car, you plug it in, you have a little coax coming in, plug that into your handheld, and then you've got even better reception because you have a better antenna, because the ones that come with them are only about that big, and you get a much bigger one that works a lot better for your top of your car. And then once you understand enough of using that little handheld to go on HF, then I recommend this G90. There's other small, what they call QRP radios. QRP means low power. There's probably about a half a dozen other small ones, but this one puts out 20 watts. Most of the other ones put out either 10 watts, 15 watts, or 10 watts, or 5 watts max. This will put out 1 watt to 20 watts. So I really like this one. The other one have larger screens, but I can see this okay. And this one's the cheapest, too, at $470-some-odd. I don't remember exactly what I paid for it. But like I say, I can send you the link for this radio. I can send you the link for the base antenna for this radio for 10 meters. And I can even show you mine. I'll take a picture. It's real easy to put up. Nothing to it. The antenna comes with directions. So the antenna's $100. The radio's almost $500. And then you're probably going to need 50 feet of coax at another $50, $40, something like that, with the two ends on it. And you're on the air. That's it. You're on the air. So, yeah, we'll email. And, yeah, that's the one right there. Send me an email, and I'll send you all the links. And, yeah, I like that one. Anybody else here have any questions about ham radio or drinking beer or anything else? Don't forget to give me that like, right? You know, because that's really important, because I really care about my channel. Yeah, right. I've got 22,000 something subscribers, and my channel's dying. So amazing, huh? I'm about ready to go get a beer. I feel like drinking a beer while we're waiting for this to start up again. God, I hope it comes back while I'm on the air here. It'd be so nice. You guys think I should go get a beer? Let me know on the chat. And if you think I should go get a beer, I will go get a beer. What do you think? Let's tune around a bit.
I started to actually think about some really graphic foul stuff that would have just been the typical on the job site. I was like, no, well, I'm really catching myself now. It, We're on the radio. I know so many years are of just whatever we want. Like, you know, I spent my whole adult life working on job sites with a bunch of, you know, guys that just cut. Right, and then we get hit radio. So you representing us for the operation.
Yeah,
I really appreciate your participation.
This ain't
shining. So far, you're the only one that participates. Everyone else keeps cutting. Well, you know, I try to be the, screw it. Well, you're trying to set a higher standard, but I really...
Well done.
Shut up and finish my watch.
This one again.
Well, I need to figure out what I was going to say because it was really good. And then every
time dang it, I can't find it.
Everything you just said. WK6U. Do you like my word salad? KM6NT.
There it is. That's what I was looking for. Still learn how to use this radio.
I just try to ramble and bamble and make up some crazy stupid stuff to get people thinking. I'm going to send you a picture of something that I have coming
up
to me that I managed to complain about. I'm going to send you a picture out here. Okay. Well, that's a picture of your thingy.
Yeah,
Bob. Oh, okay. Maybe I'll go down there and have a listen. Okay, catch you later, Max. Catch you later, Joe. I'm going to go down and listen to Chris read the list. And
oh, they're going to the swap now. 140 meters. 7240. No, they're just ending. This is the West Coast swap meet, swap net. Wow, last call. So this is on 40 meters, which is working. Oh, no, no, Larry. Boy, there's a lot of Larrys around today. AI6U, that's a call sign. My call sign is Kilo 7 Zulu Foxtrot India. 27ZFI. Yeah, so as you can see, yeah, of course, I can't transmit on that frequency right now, or I would be, and I'd really be giving you a great demonstration. So 10 meters decided to take a dump today right when I needed it, but that's just the way it happens, you know. So now here's a thing you can do. If you go on your computer or your phone to my website, cantamtrailers.com, and scroll to the bottom, you will see my online logbook with my latest contacts on it, showing the frequency, country, the name, how much power I was putting out, and all that stuff. So, and it's got flags showing the different countries all the way down the line. So go to cannedhamtrailers.com. That's C-A-N-N-E-D, cannedham, H-A-M, trailers, all one word, .com. Scroll to the bottom, and you'll see it. You'll recognize it right away because you'll see all the flags. And those are my latest contacts, probably in the last day or two. And I keep an online log going, which when you get your license, you'll have one. They're free. And, boy. Wow, 20 million people got on there at once.
So now, I don't have to follow, I don't have to be on the clock, I don't have to
I was listening because I bet that guy has gone from being a truck driver, to being a pilot escort vehicle operator, because that's what it sounded like. And they make good money. It's just a hard thing to break into. I'm certified as a pilot escort vehicle operator, and I couldn't break into the business because you pretty much have to know somebody. There's very few companies that do this. They charge a heck of a lot of money. They're highly specialized for all for good reasons. But boy, getting in, they don't just take anybody, and a lot of times they keep it in the family. Oh God! Yeah, he's fading now too. So that band's even starting to go to crap now. We'll go back to the other one, see if anything's changed here. If not, well. Oh, I never did see if, yeah, you guys said I should get a beer. Okay, I'll do that. Let me find somebody for you to listen to while I go get a beer. Besides digital. It's all digital on 10 meters. What was the, I forgot the frequency. Oh, there it is, 368, yeah. They're way faded now. And that's Minnesota. The two biggest states that come in here really good 99% of the time are Texas and Minnesota. I don't know why. It's just something about those two places that just comes booming in here really great. And so they're just like, they sound way overpowered when the band's good. When it's bad, then they sound normal. But today it's really bad, so even the Texas and Minnesota stations sound faded. So, okay, I'm going to run and get a beer. Why don't you guys get a beer, too? And I'll be right back. So I got to check the wind anyway, because we got that flag on there. Oh, no wind. Oh, yeah.
Over here.
Yeah, you want to come inside? Come on in. Come on, baby. Sabrina wanted to come say hi to everybody. Let's say hi to Sabrina. Well, hello, baby. How you doing? Yeah, she had surgery the other day. So, come here. Show us your face. Yeah, it's a beautiful face. Yes. Yes. What a beautiful doggy. Oh. Boy, there is quite the lag I'm noticing on the internet today. I want to see how... Yeah, there she is. Yeah, so let's see here. We'll tune around some more. Are you going to go back outside? Yeah, now she's going to go outside. Yeah. Nothing but digital. The digital's all nice and strong, so I know the antenna's good. And here's another thing. When the band goes to crap like that... Oh, here we go.
About 5-6, 5-6. I got some
Palomino
noise down here.
It's
going to be a little bit of
trouble. Hmm. Palomino noise, well, I know that feeling. 175, over. He's running
175 watts. Yeah, it's a KLOT TS590 transceiver, and it's driving a solid-state amplifier made by AECOM.
Why is he only putting out 175 watts? Maybe that's all he needs.
I'm using about 6 watts. And the 600 watt amp is doing about 175.
Ah, he's not driving very hard.
And the rig, doesn't even really
follow
over. Yeah. I'm sorry, repeat. Hold me.
I'm trying to find a conversation I can get in on. He's just talking. I can call CQ, but the... Kilo 7, Zulu Foxtrot, India. Somebody else ago. It's not good enough. Spanish. Okay, the band is trying to come back. It's just not good enough for QRP. I believe this is the ice station again. Yeah. Well, the nice thing is I can just turn the volume down and watch the waterfall to see when the band comes back. So not a big deal. And like I said, the band has, all the bands have just been so good for the last year or two because of the sun and the solar cycles that we're going through now. It's an 11-year cycle, and it's going to peak, I guess, in a couple of years. So we've still got, that means we've still got 4 or 5 years left of really good conditions before it starts going to sleep again. Now, that doesn't mean you can't still communicate around the world when the sun goes to sleep, then you just need more power. And so by the time that happens in my lifetime, if I'm still alive, you always got to think about that. By then I will have a nice amplifier. I don't have one now. My biggest radio puts out 200 watts by itself. I have two of them that put out 200 watts by themselves. One is a tube radio, and the other one, of course, is not tube, a newer one with chips and transistors and stuff. I like using the tube radio because it's just a lot cleaner, both on transmit and receive. And it's an older one. It's from the 1960s, I guess. It's an old Yaesu 101. Puts out 200 watts. Oh, I'm sorry, not a Yaesu 101. I was thinking of another radio. It's an old Kenwood 520 SE, and it's manual tuning with a knob and dial and all that. That's what I really like about it. No programming at all, because they didn't have chips back then. They didn't have programming back then. So it's just like your TV was, with tubes and everything. And you manually change the dial for tuning. You don't push buttons. So I really like that. That's why I like using that thing. It's way easier to use. If you use the newer radios, you've got to learn how to program, and that sucks. I hate it. Well, long pushes, short pushes, double pushes. You have to remember all that shit for each different function, and I can't stand it. So the bands are – I'm on 10 meters, and 10 meters was really good this morning, John. And I talked to Slovenia, up, you know, by Hungary and all that, on this little thing with 20 watts. I don't know if you've been tuned in long enough to see it, but there it is. That's my new 20 watt radio for QRP. I've talked on it on 5 watts a lot all over the world, and doing real QRP. And then most of the time I talk on 20 watts or 10 watts, but when I want to do QRP, I go down to 5 and do just fine. Anyway, so I've been playing with this radio for 2 weeks. And so I planned this thing out because yesterday the band was really good. 10 meters was really good. And this morning I talked to Slovenia when I got on. So I went, okay, we're going to do it today because it's sunny outside. So if you watch the beginning of the video, I put up the whole antenna system and everything out here in front of everybody with 4 or 5 people that were here. And we've been playing with it ever since. And the band has just gone to shit. So 10 meters sucks right now. 40 meters is good, but I can't talk on 40 yet because I don't have my general yet. I can go on any frequency you want if you want to try this. I would prefer probably down around, 356, 28.356 if you want to try it. Let me know in here if you want to tune to 28.356 and we'll try it. I don't know if we'll hear each other because, like I say, 10 meters has gone to crap. I did talk to Minnesota a little while ago, but it was just a 5.3. It was very, very horrible reception, but it's still, I managed to do it. I did it on live on the air. Yeah, you missed it. Packing to leave tomorrow. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, call sign is Kilo 7 Zulu Foxtrot India. Kilo 7 Zulu Foxtrot India. K7ZFI. Let me tune the radio real quick. There, it's tuned. Now I got a 1-to-1. Oh, that'll work. That's the best it's tuned up all day. So, all right, I'm there if you want to call. See, you let me know when you're ready to call. This is great that you're on here, John. We can do this. I just hope it works. It would. It would have worked this morning. It would have worked any time yesterday. Yeah, Kilo 7, Zulu Foxtrot, India, K7ZFI. Give me all your power. You got 1,500 watts? Aim your beam towards northern Nevada, Reno, Nevada, if you have a beam. Got the beam on it. And let me know on here that you're actually trying in case I don't hear you, so I know we're not waiting for nothing. I don't know your call sign either. This would be great if we can hook up. So far, I don't hear anything. There's a dog here. I don't hear nothing yet. Ooh, is that you tuning? I heard somebody tuning on that frequency. He's probably getting the radio station all warmed up and tuned in. There's somebody talking just a few cycles down. But I'm on 28.356. Boy, I heard you there. This is Kilo 7, Zulu Foxtrot, India. I heard you, John, but I didn't get your call sign. Can you give me a little more power, maybe, or get that beam on me? Kilo 5, something, something. Fox, I think. I heard Kilo 5 and that's it, John. Try it again. Kilo 7, Zulu Foxtrot, India here, John. I'm barely hearing you. Kilo 5, something, Hotel Foxtrot, Kilo 7, ZFI. Oh, somebody's on 27.356. Hi, Bill Vargo. Yeah, I'm on 28.356. Nothing heard, Kilo 7, Zulu Foxtrot, India, clear and listening. It's just, the band is just terrible today. I heard you, though. I couldn't get your, I got Kilo 5 something Hotel Foxtrot, I think. And I didn't get the rest of it. So, but I did hear you. November 5, Oscar Delta X-ray. Is that you, Bill Vargo? And you're receiving on 27.356. I'm on 28.356. Oh, there's another tune. I heard you tune. This is Kilo 7, Zulu Foxtrot, India, standing by. CQ, 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 Kilo 7, Zulu Foxtrot, India, Kilo 7, Zulu Foxtrot, India, calling. CQ, CQ, CQ. You're off frequency. I hear you, but you're off frequency. You sound a little off frequency there, but I do hear you. I'm on 28.356. Oh, Bill Vargo, well, can you hear me? Can you hear me? I'm just not getting out on this antenna in this situation with the band this way. I got out to Minnesota earlier, and I was only 5'3 there. Kilo 7, Zulu Foxtrot, India, listening. Oh, this is terrible. What a bummer. What a bummer. We got two other ham radio operators on here. I can hear one of them. Bill Largo, why don't you try transmitting? Let me see if I can hear you. Give me all the power you got and point the beam my way, Northern Nevada. Yeah, if I went in and got on the big radio, you'd hear me, but I'm only putting out 20 watts on this guy. And it's been good for 2 weeks until today. The band went south on us. So, darn. Too bad. I'm going to do it again this evening. I'll make sure and do this again on a good day. Yeah, go ahead and try calling me. I'll listen for you. Get the volume up. Northern Nevada is where you want to point your beam. Nothing. Yeah, you and John will probably end up talking to each other. I don't know how far apart you are. Let's see, you're off. You're an N5 and he's a kilo 5. You might be too close on 10 meters. You probably get each other on 40 meters, though. Yeah, nothing at all, Bill. Or John, nothing. Yeah, nothing. Yeah, the band just decided to take a dump on us today and ruin our little party. Yeah, ruining our little party. Kilo 7, Zulu Foxtrot, India. Kilo 7, Zulu Foxtrot, India. Kilo 7, Zulu Foxtrot, India. Calling CQ 10 meters. CQ, 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 CQ.
Kilo 7, Zulu Foxtrot, India. Calling. Kilo 7, Zulu Foxtrot, India. Calling. Kilo 7, Zulu Foxtrot, India. Calling. CQ, 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 10 meters. I hear somebody tuning. Did you hear that? Yeah. Yeah, you're tuning. All right, give it a shot. That's a good tune. Give it a shot. That was a good spike. Call me. Let's try it. So on. I'm not hearing anything. If I can't hear you, you're definitely not going to hear me. Yeah, we're just going to have to try it again, like later on this evening. I'll come out here, I'll start a fire, and I'll start another stream. And in the meantime, we can just drink beer and talk about this stuff if you want to do that. No, not today, they're not, John. Any other time. Any day in the last 2 weeks, we've been just great.
Even this morning, but not now. It's been horrible since I turned it on. I contacted one station in Minnesota, barely, and they know me. Oh, you're in New Mexico? Okay. And where's John? John, where are you at? I forget. I know I heard it some other time. But Bill Vargo, you and I got to try this again. We got to try talking to each other here, like this evening or tomorrow. Oh, is my phone going dead? Oh, my battery's going dead. Hold on. God, I've been doing this a lot. Yeah, my battery almost went dead. I didn't realize how long I'd been on. Yeah, 40 meters. I was on there a little while ago, and it's great, but I can't talk on it. Oh, John's Oklahoma City. Okay. I really want to visit your area, John. And I was going to do it a couple years ago when I was going to do the Route 66. And, of course, COVID put the kibosh on all that. But I really want to see your area. I'm really interested in Oklahoma, Minnesota, the Upper Peninsula, you know, all these different places I want to see. And they're all to the east of me, you know, because I live on the west side of the country. So I am going to see you eventually. But we'll try this again on the next one. You're getting ready to leave, I know. So are you going to have a mobile HF rig, John? Because that's what I did all this for. So I'd be able to set up mobile on HF. What I need now is a really good antenna to put on this mast. I don't know if you saw the mast. Go back to the beginning of the video, the live stream, when we get off, and you can see me setting up the mast. It's a 30-foot mast for a trailer. It's a flagpole. And I got a little drill thing to drill a hole in the ground for the base, for the plastic sleeve. And I just put the mast in there, and I got a connector up here to hold the mast, and I can also guy wire it if it's windy. Oh, your 857D. Yeah, those are good radios. Okay. I want one of those, but I got this now. Of course, the 857 puts out more power, but what do they put out, 50 or 100 watts? Don't they put out like, I'm not sure. I think it's 50 watts, 60 watts, something like that. Yeah, hamsticks. Yeah, there's a hamstick up here. Yeah, and I'm also, but I'm going to get a shark antenna for here, for this mast. The shark antenna with some counterpoise is a really great antenna. They put out 100? Okay, that's good. Yeah, that's good to know. I do want to get one because it's the neatest little mobile HF rig around. I'd really like to have one, but boy, you can't, they're hard to find and they're very expensive, but I'll find one. But for low power, this thing is just so great. Now they do make a 100 watt linear amplifier for this radio, but I heard that it doesn't do real well. And to stay away from it. So I'm going to have to check on that a little bit more. But then you're talking about more equipment, whereas, you know, for a smaller compact size, I can do a 859 for, you know, they're run, you find them for, you know, $500-$600, I guess. Yeah, now I've done that up at the cemetery, the 140-year-old cemetery, when I went up there for field day, and I took my Yaesu 707, which is a 100-watt rig, and it's 12 volts, and I took that up, and I have another mast. I can use this one for the same thing, but I have another mast that doesn't go quite as high, and I used that for an inverted V, and I got out real good on that, too. It's 10, 20, and 40. Yeah, it's 10, 20, and 40 meters, a wire antenna with balun, and it's all in one piece. So it's like three wires, and they each have their own balun, and it all goes to one feed point. And I can use that also. I have an MFJ made just for 10 meters. I use that up there at the cemetery. So I do have other types of antennas, and I'll be playing with homebrew antennas mostly. First one I'm going to build is a 5/8 wave wire antenna. It'll be about 21 feet tall. I'll use it on my fiberglass pole that I have, and with counterpoise, and we'll do that next to Walker Lake, and that ought to be good. I wish I had more room in this van. Oh! Well, yeah. Unless you can shove it in there somewhere, I'd love to have it. 450 watts, that's what I had a million years ago when I was a tube amp. Oh, that'd be great. I'd love to have that. That'd be great. That's what I was doing back in the 1970s when I was on CB. I had a 450-watt linear amplifier that worked on 11 meters. And my first DX contact was Japan on CB at around midnight from Northern California. It was snowing outside. And I talked to this guy in Japan, and he was only putting out 1 watt from a fishing boat. And then, but that water makes for a great ground plane. And then I talked to another guy after him. It was Christmas Eve. I'll never forget this. I had a President Washington radio tweaked to work on 10 meters, which is totally illegal. Oh, okay. On QRZ. All right. Well, I don't even have a pen out here. I need your call sign again. I never got it. Do I have a pen or a pencil anywhere here? Oh, God, I don't. I don't have a single pencil or pen out. When I go to get another beer, John, when I go to get another beer, I'll grab a pen and I can write down your call sign. Then I'll go to your QRZ page. K5 Chief, CHF, Chief. You know, I've always thought that you look kind of Native American. You have that look to you. And if you live in Oklahoma, President Hamilton, yeah, all the President series were really good radios. Yeah, I had a President Washington, and I used the heck out of it. Yeah, you being in Oklahoma City, and just the way you look and your style and everything, I always kind of wondered if you didn't have a little bit of Native American in you. John. So K5 Chief, CHF. That's great. Let me look that. Oh, I don't want to leave the page. Oh, I can bring up another one. Let me bring up QRZ. And I'll show it to everybody here. I don't even know if I have a link to QRZ on this one. I got to put it on here. There we go. QRZ logbook app. I don't want the logbook app. I just want my logbook and all that. QRZ.com. That's what I want. Hold on a minute. You do have some in you, okay. And you're going to be going to some native sites. Yeah, I lived with the Indians growing up. And the tribe is local to here, even. I grew up near here in my teenage years, anyway. I have to sign in here. Call sign or username. K7ZFI. Yep. Passwords. Okay, and I'm there. Never save that. Don't really ask me that all the time. Oh. What? They couldn't log me in. Jeez. Maybe it's under the old call sign, K6. Oh, wait. G6ZFI. Okay, that one's not valid, so let's see. Okay, I never logged in from this computer. Well, maybe it's another. Oh, I still have the old password on this one. Okay. Alrighty here. So let's see. I'm going to look you up here, John, and then I'll show it to everybody unless you don't want me to. Tell me if you don't want me to. K5 Chief. K5CHF. There we go. The microphone is in the way of the keypad. The microphone wire. Well, your name is John. Why does it say? Oh, it's not K6. It's K5. Sorry, wait a minute. There's a K6 CHF, and his name is Pat. K5 CHF. There you are, John D. Okay, Oklahoma City. Okay, let's see here. Get the timer to work. My humble station. Ooh, what's that little Scout you got there? That's a neat looking little radio. Scout 555. There's some of the women that you have photographed, some of the stars and stuff. Get rid of mice and rays and things. Okay. All right. Well, yeah. All right. Well, here's John's QRZ page. And this is what we have as ham radio operators for. We keep track of everything here. We have a logbook and information about your station and yourself, stuff like that, you know. So, and he's K5CHF. You guys can't go to this without having a license. So you can't really go to it. But anyway. Well, I'm getting hungry now, too. And the more when I get hungry, I get kind of sick to my stomach. Oh, you're going to Chiricahua National Monument? Oh, geez. I have a very good-looking female friend who's there right now. She's been there for a week, I think, so she's probably getting ready to leave. But she and but I don't know if you watch her. Catherine Gregory, C-A-T-H type, Catherine Gregory on YouTube. She just had a video of there this morning. She normally hikes and does all kinds of backpacking trips and everything. She's gorgeous. If you don't know her already, yeah, Catherine. Yeah, she's there right now. So unless she already left, but she just put out a video. Yeah, but they've had inclement weather, so she just kind of ran around the Bisbee area and the, let's see, and she went and visited Tombstone, and she visited Bisbee, but she camped in the Chiricahua Mountains. So, oh, you saw that video. You subbed. Okay, yeah. So I don't know if she's still there or not, but yeah, I watched it. I love waking up and having coffee with Catherine on Sunday mornings because her video is just so fantastic. Let me see if I don't see anybody else on 10 meters anywhere other than FT8. All I see is FT8 going. Here you go, 398. Oh, okay. I will. I've got the bell rung on you and everything, John. Yeah, somebody pretty strong on dot 398. He's the only one on the whole band that I can hear talking. Because otherwise, it's all FTA. There's a guy on 405, too. Very faint. Boy, I have never seen this band this bad. Even when the sun's asleep, I've just never seen it this bad. That's absolutely amazing. Doggone it. What a shame. You want to hear yourself? Why don't you call me on 40 meters, John? So at least you can hear what you sound like. I won't be able to answer you, but call. Let's tune to a station on 40 meters. Let's go to .240, 7.240. There's nobody on it right now. And give me a call. Call me a couple of times, and everybody can hear what you sound like on the radio here, okay? It's very quiet on 40 meters right now. Maybe that means 40 meters went to crap, too, because it was good earlier. No, I see other people talking on the waterfall. So go to 7.240. Yes, 7.240. And call me. Call me a few times and then just say no contact. We're waiting for John. He's probably got to go way in the other room. Should have your computer right next to your ham radio. Chris, you might have to change antennas, tune around, whatever, I don't know. 7.240. Beam the beam this way. I know you should be able to get through on 40. Maybe not. Maybe you'll have to go to 20. New Mexico, I should be able to get you on 40. Okay, we're waiting for John. Let me know if you tried and I didn't hear it. So far, I haven't heard anything. 7.240. I see people talking above me and below me, so I know it's working. I just don't know if the band's right for, if this band's right for our distance. You know, that critical frequency. And critical angle and all that stuff. One thing I'm surprised about is without the microphone, this phone has worked fine for audio all this time. The stream is now over 2.5 hours old, and with my old phone, which was the same phone, after an hour it would heat up to the point where the audio wouldn't work anymore, and with this one it does. That's why I got the mic in the first place. But now this mic doesn't work for some reason. I gotta figure that out. I don't hear anything yet, John. 7.240. But I'm waiting because there's a hell of a lag on the internet out here today. Hell of a lag. God, you are so faded. Oh, my God. You're so faded. That's not like, it's not supposed to be like that on 40 meters. I did hear you. I heard ZFI. I heard K7 ZFI. Very low. Barely. Barely hear you. Did not work. So even that band is kind of screwed up. All right, let's try 20 meters. Let's go to... He's tuning. We can hear you tuning. But that's a very faint signal. Oh, you went by it. There you go. There you go. But still, it's really faded. Dang it. All right, let's try 20 meters. Let's see, 20 meters. Now I have to remember, 20 meters is 14. Let's try 14.30. Oh, no. Yeah, well, the band's working for you and him, but I heard you, but I could barely hear you. Barely hear you. You didn't even register on the waterfall. I barely heard my call sign in there. But you got N5ODX. That's great. Bill Vargo. All right, let's try 20 meters. Go to 14.230. 14.230. Let's try that and see if it works. Yeah, I did hear you, but it was just barely. And I didn't even, of course, I probably would have tried to answer you, even though it's illegal. But yeah, I did hear you, barely, just barely. And I didn't hear Bill Vargo at all. So 14.230, yes, 14.230. I don't see anybody talking on 20 meters. You know what? All the bands suck today. Let's try 14.230. And if that doesn't work, I'll give it up. You'll have to tune up again. Yeah, okay, Bill. We'll go to 14.230. See if you can hook up there with John. And I'll see if I can hear you guys talking. So that'd be the best way. That way you're actually calling somebody. So you guys get a QSO going. I hear tuning. You guys get a QSO going on 20 meters here and see if I can pick you up. I should have been able to get you on 10. I should have been able to hear you on 20. I mean, on 40. And I dang sure should be able to hear you on 20. But... Somebody's just tuning the crap out of their radio. You want me to go to 14.200? All right. All right, I'm on 14.200. Yeah, try it on 14.200. You must be an extra. I legally, if I was a general, I can only go down to 14.225. That to 350.
and at a different signal level, so it's hard to really be overly critical.
There's somebody just 202 kilocycles off from there. Yeah. Yeah, go to 14,225. Because we're both, well, I'm not a general. I'm a tech. John's a general. You must be an extra. Try 14,225. 14,225. Boy, there's somebody on 14,227 too. Of course, one thing nice about this radio, I can shift the bandwidth from one side to the other on receive, so I can tune somebody that's really close out. This is a neat little radio. Right now, I've got the bandwidth of 2700 for receive, and I can move one side or the other of that and on the bandwidth, and it'll settle down. Are you guys trying on 14,225? I'm not hearing anything. Not hearing anything. Well, all the bands suck today. That's just all there is to it. I've got to see where my dog is real quick, because when I open the gate, she wanders around the back lot. She always ends up lost over at the far corner on the other side of the shop, and I have to go rescue her because she doesn't know how to get out of there for some reason. But I'll be right back, so I have to go get the dog. And you know what? I need another beer. So I'm going to get another beer. What was I going to do when I went in to get another beer? I forgot. Oh, that's a slow scan TV frequency. Yeah, there will be, John. All right, I'll go to 14,200 and just listen. John can listen too, but you go ahead and call us on 14,200 and see if we can hear. I didn't hear anything before when I was there. But John and I can only listen on that frequency. A writing stick, yeah. Oh, that's what I wanted. Yeah, thanks, Greg. A writing stick. I'll get a beer and a writing stick. Although, I don't think I'll ever forget John's call sign now. But I do need to write down Bill Bargo's. John is K5 Chief, CHF. So, let me get a beer and a writing stick and find the dog, and I'll be right back. Okay? Here, you can look at that. See if John can get, or Bill Bargo can get in while we're listening. Thank you.
We're inside. Hey, baby. Well, I don't know if you called. First, I heard you. Come on in. Hey, baby. There, Sabrina's in again. She's down there. So, anyhow, we got a writing stick. Yeah, this morning I talked to Sierra 5, 8 November, Milo in Slovenia on 28.453 using 20 watts. So, and John is K5CHF. All right. We will talk, John, on 10 meters for sure. We just have to let the band recover. So, yeah, 14.220 would be where we were at, I think. Yeah, where we're at right now on 20 meters. So, stupender. Are you a ham radio operator? I mean, it doesn't matter. I'm just wondering if you are. Nice to meet you. But that's in the extra class. I can only go down to 14.225. And what did he say? I think 14.225 is slow scan TV. 14.200 to 14.230 is slow scan freak. Yeah. Nice to meet you. Oh, you're clueless. Okay. Well, we're talking all about ham radio here today. You can watch the whole stream. It's pretty long. But I showed myself setting up a mobile antenna for this trailer here. I'm going to be going camping, and I want to be able to talk around the world on a ham radio on HF, single sideband, when I'm out. So I built a antenna system that goes up 30 feet that's portable that I can take with me. And we're trying all that out now. The only thing is, today the conditions for ham radio are terrible. And they've been really, really good, you know, lately. And today they just decided to take a dump. And I can't call it. You know, I talked to one guy today in Minnesota when I first fired up, and that was it. He could barely hear me, and I could barely hear him. And yet this morning I talked to Slovenia, which is near Hungary. No problem, on the same radio. Different antenna, but same radio. And today the conditions are just terrible. But yeah, we talk about during the stream here. We've talked about where you can go to get your license. Amtestonline.com is where you go. You can study there, get your technician license. Then you can get on 10 meters HF here, talk all over the world. But then you go for your general license, and that opens up all the other bands to you. Because with a technician license, you've only got a small space on 10 meters that you can use on HF. I had it down lower earlier, and I put it up higher. What it is just today the bands are really bad. So I'm going to leave it set up. I'm going to bring the antenna down so it doesn't blow over in the wind. But I'm going to, you know, when the band gets good again, I'll come out here and try it again from here. But really, I just wanted to get the mechanics of it set up today. I wasn't really interested in it would have been a lot of fun to make contacts all over the world live on the internet here. There's a couple of other friends of mine that are ham radio people in here, ham radio operators. So it would have been great to talk to them and have a good time, but it just didn't work today. I mean, this is the way my luck goes. This is, when I put something on the air, like when I go fishing, if I don't have my cell phone with me,
and I'm just fishing and running the rivers, man, I'm catching big old trout, cutthroat, whatever, all over the place. Hookjaw browns, you name it. Just wham, one right after the other, and throwing them back, and wham, another one, you know, throwing them back. I do a live stream of me fishing in a place where I know there's fish, and I've caught fish all my life. I don't catch a damn thing. I don't see a single one jump. I don't see nothing. Turn the live stream off, wham, we get a fish again. So, same thing seems to happen with ham radio. Okay, John. Okay, great. I'm glad you came in. And yeah, seeing as how, let's try and hook up while you're out on your trip too. So be visiting 10 meters a lot, and we can also get together with each other. Let me, I don't want to put my phone number over the air. Is your email address on your QRZ page? Because if it is, John, and you too, Bill Vargo. Okay, Bill Vargo sent me an email. I will get your guys' information, and we'll try and hook up more often on 10 meters until I get my general license, and then we can go all over the place. Yeah, Greg, you have the same kind of luck I do. Yeah, he has the same kind of luck that I do. And yeah, Bill, I'll go ahead and check my email. And okay, good. I'll see you. I'll get your email address on QRZ. So, John and you, Bill, I'll give you guys my texting phone number so we can text each other and get on the air when the bands are good and play with it. You're going to love this radio. I mean, this thing is just amazing. Bill, I don't know if you've heard of the G90, but this thing is just, it's been amazing. I've talked to people on QRP, even. You know, 5 watts. I've talked all over the world on 5 watts with it. And just with a little tunable ground plane antenna. It's really a CB antenna, but you can tune it to 10 meters because it's got a sliding top hat, capacitance hat. And you can tune it from 11 meters down to 10 meters or up to 10 meters. And it's just great, you know. It's been a great antenna. It's only $100 for that antenna. It's only a couple of feet off my roof. It's a great antenna. You know, it's like 21 feet long, the vertical on it, and it's a ground plane, so it doesn't need any counterpoise. I see people on 10 meters up a little higher here. Oh, no, that's 20 meters. Okay, let me go back to 10 meters, see what's going on. Is there anybody on 10? There is nothing. Oh god, I finally saw me phase away. God. Kilo 7 Zulu Foxtrot India on 20 watts.
Okay, I hear a bunch of Kilo 7.
Kilo 7 Zulu Foxtrot India on 20 watts. Yeah, I'm actually doing 20 watts. It will go down to 5 watts, but 10 meters has been really bad today. How is your copy now? You're coming in 5.7 to 5.9 in northern Nevada. QSL, and yeah, the band's fading right now as we speak. I've been trying to work this all day because it's a new mobile setup with a G90, and I've been talking all over the world on 5 to 20 watts all week long. I come out here to try it out here, and boom, the band goes to crap.
Yeah, I worked so many hours on that thing.
QSL. Yeah, it's the Xiegu, Xiegu, XIE, X-ray India Echo Golf uniform. I call it Xiegu. That's about the best that I've heard from anybody else. So what is your what is your location again and your call sign? QSL, and what's the call sign again? November 1 Delta Radio, what? November 1 Delta Radio Station, Sierra, in other words. QSL. Boy, this band is tricky today, fading in and out all over the place. But I sure appreciate the comeback because you helped me prove that my station will work in this configuration. And I appreciate that a lot. I'm a new technician on HF, and I'm working on my general license as we speak. Yeah. All righty, thank you so much for the contact. Kilo 7, Zulu, Foxtrot, India saying 73s. Good, I finally talked to somebody in Boston. David, okay, his name was David. Finally, it happened. Jeez, the band finally came. You know, it usually does get the best in the afternoon around 3, 3:30. And actually, that's about going into the time where I can usually talk to Japan or Russia. So, but I'm glad finally made a contact today. With this whole live stream and stuff. That was just, boy, I'm glad he heard. When he came back to me, I went, oh my God, he's getting me, okay. And yeah, he knew my name because he looked me up on QRZ. I don't recognize the call sign, so I don't believe we've ever talked to each other before. But that was Boston, November, India, Delta, Romeo, Sierra, or November 1, Delta Romeo Sierra. That's what it is. November 1, because there has to be a number in there. So I probably told him India, but November 1, Delta Romeo Sierra. So N1DRS. And he was in and out. Normally, it doesn't fade that quickly in and out either. So the band is just starting to move back into being good here. Maybe. And like he said, somebody was doing FT8 right off of our sideband a little bit. That's one of the things I hate about FT8, all the digital stuff. I think they should have their own frequencies like CW. I don't think they should be allowed in with the voice. Even CW, I don't like being in with the voice because those guys, they don't hear anything. And so they go ahead and they start talking. And, you know. Australia? Did you get Australia today? Yeah, okay. Because, yeah, I talked to Australia, too. Japan, Australia, New Zealand. And good to meet you, Tommy, by the way. On K7ZFI here in northern Nevada, if you want to look me up. And we've been trying out my portable station here that I just put together. I've been using this radio on my big antenna all week in the house. And I've been all over the world with it on 5 to 20 watts. And so today I finally set up the whole portable part of it with the portable mast and everything. And I did that earlier in the stream about 3 hours ago. So you can see how that all sets up with my trailer. This is, I restore old vintage trailers. This one hasn't been restored yet. I'm still using it, but I got other trailers in the midst of being restored right now. You can see that on my website, candhamtrailers.com, which also has a copy of my logbook that gets updated automatically from QRZ. So if you scroll all the way down to the bottom of that page, you'll see that. But I build and restore vintage trailers for fun and profit. I'm retired now. And I'm studying right now for my general license. So Kilo 7 Zulu Foxtrot India is my call sign. Yeah, just this morning I talked to Slovenia. Sierra 5-8 November on .425 or 452, and actually it was 452.5. Sometimes these guys are off by, you know, half a kilocycle or 5 kilocycles. Is that a kilocycle? Yeah, 5 kilocycles. But I talked to him 5-9 on 20 watts, no problem. So, and I've talked to Australia and New Zealand on as little as 5 watts even. All over this country on 5 watts, and Mexico, South America, yeah, all over the dang place. So, at least I finally made a contact on 10 meters. And it was only inside the country, but we might get some... we might get some DX going here now that it's after 3. I don't know if the band will come back that good today or not. I'm tuning around looking at the waterfall. I'm not even listening. And I don't see anything but digital happening. So, yeah, it's been a crappy day for the bands. But it's a good day for beer and sunshine. And here I am inside the trailer. So... alrighty, I think I'm going to go ahead and kill the live stream now because I've been out here talking and playing for 3 hours. I'm on my second beer, so I'm going to enjoy the rest of the day with the dog here a little bit because I've been ignoring her, and she gets bored easy because she's blind. She's been wandering around the lot here getting lost and stuff. So we'll do it again. And it was good to meet the ham radios operators on here that I met today. Unfortunately, I only got to talk to two on the radio. It was just a terrible day for conditions, and that's it. So I'm sorry about that. Nothing I can do about it. It's, you talk to God. not Obama. He really thinks he can control the weather, but he can't. You got to talk to God about that. So just a joke, friends. But yeah, I'm going to be using this trailer and this ham setup and running around all over the dang place, setting up to do DX and local meaning inside the country, on HF. And as soon as I get my general, then I'll really be going nuts. So that'll be really cool. So with that, I'm going to go ahead and shut this all off. I'll give you one more look at what I got going here. Let's see, can I unplug the telephone because it was low on power? I'm sure I can because I've recharged it for a while now. And I'm running the G90 right there with a 12-volt, 24-ampere-hour LiFePO battery by Talent Cell. I love their batteries. This one's been doing me... I can run it like this for 3 or 4 days. I never did run it below half power last week when I started running it. So, and then I also have power like that little guy right there with solar for recharging. So, and I can recharge this battery off that thing also. So I have all the power requirements taken care of here. And outside, I'll show you the antenna. It's just a ham stick up, hi baby. It's just a ham stick up 30 feet in the air, and I didn't put my flag on there. But as you can see, it's just a mast. There's a hole dug. I drilled the hole with this drill here and stuck it right in the ground with a plastic insert. And then I also have a ground running inside the trailer from here, ground wire for lightning protection, basically. But, you know, look at this. We don't have any lightning today. And I think maybe if I would ground the right at the feed point, the other side of the antenna, that might help my SWR too. I'm going to try that next time. I just didn't get a ground wire up to the feed point. I don't know if that'll help or not. Either that, or I don't know if counterpoise would help either. It's a ham stick, so it's supposed to work without counterpoise. Loaded at the bottom. I'm going to get a shark antenna loaded in the middle. Those antennas seem to be real good. If you follow Walt, what is he, K-O-4-G-O or something like that, K-O-G-4 or something, Kilo 4 Oscar Golf Oscar, I think is his call sign, and he's on YouTube, and I've been learning about antennas from him. He goes out and tries, he's got a G90, that's when I decided to buy one when I saw his. And he goes out all over the place on the East Coast, usually near the water, because he lives near the water. And he sets up, he plays with all kinds of antennas. Just recently, he made an antenna out of a slinky. I thought that was pretty cool. Being an engineer and having his mind, he figured out the length of a slinky by you looking at the diameter and everything. And he got that thing to tune up, and he talked DX all over the place using that on 20 watts. And it was a lot of fun. You should go watch his videos. He's got a great channel. So, alrighty, I'm going to go ahead and cut it short here. I want to thank you all, what few of you are here, for watching today and helping me have fun. I can't wait to get out in a real camping atmosphere where I'm going to have a lot less noise to deal with. Zero, as a matter of fact. Around here, I got so much AC noise, it's terrible. It makes reception really bad. I'm sure it doesn't help my transmission much either. So, yeah. Thanks a lot, everybody. And we'll catch you all later. Let me see if I can use... I didn't mean to do that. That was an accident. I hit the wrong button. Because I haven't ended the stream yet. But anyway, let me see if I can find my... There it is. That's what I was looking for. Hi, Robert. yeah, I'm leaving now. So you came in a little late, Robert. Just go watch the rest of the stream. Let me find my outro. It's in here somewhere, I think. Yeah. All right, there it is. Okay. Let's do the outro. Let's do the national anthem. All right, guys. Kilo 7, Zulu Foxtrot, India. Wishing you all 73s, and I will be clear on your final.
Ladies and gentlemen, our national anthem.
Mm-hmm.